South Carolina as Jamie McMurray, who beat Jeff Gordon out of the pits to claim the lead, brings him down for the restart.
Now, he's starting on the inside, and to me, that might be a mistake. We'll see.
This is the first time we've had a double file restart at Darlington in the Sprint Cup Series.
Green flag at 50 laps complete, and McMurray takes off.
When you take off like that, it doesn't make any difference.
24, I don't know what happened to him. He just didn't go.
That looks like last Saturday night.
I was going to say, one of his Achilles heel all year long has been his restart.
Three wide down the back straightaway. As they race for fifth place, it's Denny Hamlin. Way down the inside, Newman was the meat in the sandwich. The 39 had to get hard on the brakes. Hamlin gets the spot, then Kane in sixth, Newman in seventh.
I think that's something those guys, Hamlin and some of the guys that raced last night, saw that was possible to do. Take that thing in on the apron, put a slide job on the guy, and get up in front of him and go.
Denny Hamlin won last night's Nationwide Series race here.
But back to that three wide down the back straightaway. Ryan Newman in that 39 has enough experience here. He knows somebody has to do some give and take, and he obviously did the give and there.
Bobby Labonte has hit the wall. The number 71 Chevrolet.
He's got a little more than a strike down the right side of that car. You can see all the bars in the back of the car that are all bent in. In fact, he's got a tire down.
Yeah. Around he goes.
No caution yet.
You know, Larry, as big as the apron is here, and a car just takes a slow spin like that, unless there's debris on the track.
Joey Logano spins off turn four and crashes the inside wall. That will bring out caution flag number two.
Now, I wonder if it had anything to do with Bobby Labonte. Bobby Labonte had trouble off that turn just a lap before.
Well, let's first look at what happened to the former champion, Bobby Labonte, in the 71.
Here he is right here in the 71. Oh, that car just, I don't know any other way to explain it. Got in, did he get into Logano?
No, no contact, I don't believe. Now watch the orange Toyota of Logano do the same thing in the same place one lap later.
That thing just came around. I mean, just snapped around just like Bobby Labonte's car did.
But Darrell, he looked awfully high in that corner right there coming through there that time.
Logano looking forward at Labonte.
See, Bobby's car, just the back end snapped. And Mike, I saw this in practice and qualifying on new tires. The cars would be a little squirrely for a lap or two on new tires.
It happened to Joe Nemechek in practice, and he climbed out of the car and said, I just don't know what happened. That doesn't happen.
And that looks like what happened to Bobby Labonte. He just snapped.
I think we'll see what happened to Joey Logano in his 20 car here going down into turn three and four. You can hear him starting to really pedal the throttle. The thing just got loose with him.
Yeah.
Elliott Sadler snuck by on the inside there. And Logano, Matt, I don't know how hard a hit that was to the inside wall, but he got it pretty good.
He tagged it pretty well, Mike. As you see the replay, Greg Zipidelli asked him what happened. He said the car was just way too loose. He said, was it the track in that section or just the car? He said, just the car.